This is discrete circuit of DTL NAND gate. To study this, we have to first consider over some basic points. This first number, the voltage across the base and emitter junction of a transistor is according to its region. That is, when the transistor is in saturation region, the voltage VVE is equal to 0.75 volt. And when the transistor is in active region, it is 0.7 volt. And when it is in cutoff region, it is 0.65 volt. The same case is with the diode also. The voltage across diode is 0.75 volt when the diode is in saturation. When diode is in active region, it is 0.7 volt. And when diode is in cutoff region, then it is 0.65 volt. Second point is, when the logic 1, that is plus 5 volt, is given to the collector junction of a transistor and the emitter junction is connected to the ground, then the voltage VCE, that is at this point, the voltage is equal to 0.2 volt when it is in saturation region and it is equal to 5 volt when it is in cutoff region. As in the cutoff region, the transistor is cut off, no current is flowing, the same voltage that comes here, 5 volt. When the transistor is in cutoff, when the transistor is in saturation region, the whole current flowing through this and the V0 is approximately equal to 0.2 volt. Let us assume this transistor T0 is in saturation. Thus here the voltage, logic level voltage is 0. And here the voltage is 5 volt. So most of the current will flow in this direction across the voltage DA. This becomes in saturation. This diode becomes in saturation. And a very less amount of current will flow in this direction. So these diodes become in cutoff region. Here we have calculated the voltage at point P. Voltage point P is 0.2 plus 0.75 volt, that is 0.95 volt. 0.2 volt comes from this VI. VI, here the voltage is 0.2 volt. And across this saturated diode, the voltage will be 0.75 volt. So the VP is 0.95 volt, okay. Now, we are calculating at the voltage at point VB. VB is equal to VP across this voltage and this voltage, VP minus VD1 minus VD2. And as this, we have assumed the very less amount of current is flowing in this direction. So the diodes are in cutoff region. So we have taken the voltage 0.65 volt for both the diodes. And thus we are getting the voltage of minus 0.35 volt. Here the voltage, at least we require 0.75 volt to make this transistor in saturation. But we are getting minus 0.35 volt, which is not sufficient or which cannot make this transistor in saturation. That is, this transistor is in cutoff region. This transistor is in cutoff region. So the whole current ID will flow through this resistance RB, whose value is 20 kilo ohm. So we have also calculated the IRB value. IRB value, which is almost equal to ID, and which is equal to VB minus of minus 2. This is minus 2 volt. That is VB plus 2 by RB. VB is minus 0.35 volt plus 2 by A. The current is coming 0.08 milliampere. That is, we have also verified that this current is very, very small. We have assumed also, and this current is coming as very, very small. Now, if we give all the inputs of this gate as a logic level 0, then a higher portion of this current will flow in this direction and ID will become very less now. And due to which the transistor T2 will become in mode cutoff. And thus, we get a very clear picture of V0 as a logic level 1. Also, we can see here, if the transistor T0 is in saturation, then VI and then the current flowing from this, the VCC of the drive-in gate will flow to the ground through this transistor. That is, this transistor is sinking the current from the of the drive-in gate. This is called as current sinking. Let us take another case when each of the input is given a logic level 1. Then no current will flow in this direction. Almost all current, that is I is equal to ID, will flow through this diode D2 and this transistor T2. Thus, these D1 and D2 will become in active, that is saturation region. T2 will also become in saturation region. We can calculate VB is equal to, we can get VB is equal to 0.75 volt as this is grounded. This across this diode, we can also get 0.75 volt. Across this also, we get 0.75 volt. Thus, we can get VP here. Here we have calculated VP. VP is equal to 3 times 0.75. First time is due to this transistor, second time is due to this diode, and third time of this is due to this D1 diode. So VP is equal to 2.25 volt. Now we are interested in calculating the current flowing in this branch, IRB. As we have get the voltage VB, 0.75 volt, here we are getting minus 2 volt. The IRB can be calculated as VB minus of minus 2 by RB, that is 0.75 plus 2 by 20 to 20, 10 to the power 3. This is IRB value, 0.14 milliampere. We are getting IRB as 0.14 milliampere, and that is very small, I think so. And ID is approximately equal to I. So VCC minus VP by R is equal to I, which is equal to ID. So ID can be calculated VCC minus VP by R, and VP we have calculated as VP is equal to 2.25 volt. So VCC minus VP by R, 5 minus 2.25 by R. R value is 2 into 10 to the power 3. It is coming 1.4 milliampere. So this current is 1.4 milliampere. This current is 1.14 milliampere, 0.14 milliampere. So we can calculate IB current by subtracting ID minus IRB. So we have calculated ID minus IRB, IB is coming 1.26 milliampere. This current 1.26 milliampere is sufficient enough to drive this transistor into saturation region. And due to this, the V0 becomes 0.2 volt, that is logic 0 level. Here let us assume that transistor T2 is in saturation region and suddenly we are giving any one of the input as a 0 volt. Then the transistor T2 tends to cutoff, goes for cutoff. But as we can see here, the VP will change, will come from 2.25 volt to 0.95 volt, and these diodes become cutoff in cutoff region. No current will be allowed to flow in through this direction. This RB and minus 2 volt combination, this combination is helping the stored charge in the transistor to get discharged. This minus 2 volt is accelerating the discharging capability, that is propagation delay time will be decreased due to this, as much as you can disapply. Also there is question that why huge resistance is applied there, as we are getting for discharging this must be very less, but if you can see that in the case when the T2 is in saturation, that is each and every input is 1, then the current is flowing in this direction, also some of part of the current is flowing in this direction. If the resistance will be very less, then IB will be relatively less, and it may be possible that IB will be so much less that T2 will not be come in saturation region. So we have to see both the this is a condition of compromise, so we have to also make this large and also make this negative. This negative increases the speed of discharging of the stored charge in the transistor, and this high resistance will stop the flow of current, huge flow of current in this direction, and make this transistor in saturation. So thank you for watching this video, and please like, share and subscribe this video, and also comment in the comment section box any difficulty you have find in this this video, and also you can comment that whichever topic you want to study, we have teachers. Whatever you have any query related or non-related things, you can also ask in comment section. We will prepare for that. We have teachers of various departments. So thank you.